हेलो हेलो, लेट्स ट्राई टू सॉल्व सम प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड ऑन एलजेब्रा फ्रॉम द ESO मेंस पेपर 2018. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज द नंबर ऑफ बाइनरी ऑपरेशन ऑन अ सेट जी ऑफ थ्री एलिमेंट्स विल बी. एज वी नो दैट द नंबर ऑफ बाइनरी ऑपरेशन व्हेन द नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स आर एन, वी हैव एन टू द पावर एन square means here n equals to 3, that's why the number of binary operation will be 3 to the power 3 to the power 2, that means 3 to the power 9. So the answer is option number A. Next question is, if the order of an element in a group G is 27, then order of A cube in Z is. If order of A is 27, that simply means A to the power 27 equals to E. From this we can easily identify this E to the power 3 into 9 will be equals to E. That's why order of A 3 will be equals to 9. Next question is, the number of units in ring where R equals to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is. In ring R, every element will have an additive inverse. Okay, but not every element will have a multiplicative inverse. However, there may be some elements which do have multiplicative inverse, and we call these elements units. Means we are, what is the unit? Unit means the element with multiplicative inverse in a ring will be called as a unit of that ring. They form a group under matrix multiplication. In order to find the number of units in this ring, first you have to design a multiplication table for this ring. Here it will have dot and it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I am leaving this table to you. You can easily fill these elements. Now, in order to find out the units, what we have to do is we have to count the number and columns that contains the multiplicative identity, that is 1. For example, for this I am giving you only a hint. For this entry we will have 1 here. It means this is our unit. Suppose here we have 1, then this one will be unit. So we have to count that how many rows we have multiplicative identity, that is 1, and the answer will be 6. When you fill this multiplication table for this ring, you will have the number of units will be 6, as the 6th row will contain the multiplicative identity. Next question is, the set of natural numbers with binary operation forms an abelian group, a group, a monoid, or none of these. The set of natural numbers is not an abelian group. It is not a group because it doesn't satisfy the third property, that is existence of identity element. 0, as we know that for natural numbers, 0 is our additive identity, which is not a natural number. It is also not a monoid since it does not have a identity element. It is a semigroup, which is not given in these options. So the correct answer is option number 4. Next question is, the number of generators in the cyclic group of order 10 is. The formula for calculating the generator of a cyclic group is phi n is equals to n, n is your order, into 1 upon 1 minus p1 into 1 minus P2, 1 upon 1 minus P2 and so on, where this P1 and P2 are the prime factors of this order n. For n equals to 10, we have its factor will be 2 into 5. So, we will have this phi n will be equals to 10 into 1 minus 1 upon 2 into 1 minus 1 upon 5. It will come out as 10 into half into 4 upon 5. That is 4. So, the correct answer is option number 2, 4. Next question is, let G be the group such that a to the power 5 equals to e and ab a inverse equals to b2. For ab is in G, then order of b will be. Now, let's try to perform some operation with the help of these two identity. We are given with ab a inverse equals to b square. AB A inverse into AB A inverse will be equals to B to the power 4, as it will be AB, as it is a group, it will, by using the associative property, we will have this A inverse A will be E. It means we have AB B A inverse, that is AB square A inverse. Now replace this B square by this AB A inverse, we will have A square B A to the power minus 2 will be equals to B4. And when we calculate these in a similar fashion, we will have A cube B A to the power minus 3 will be B to the power 8. A4 B A to the power minus 4 will be B to the power 16. And A to the power 5 B A to the power minus 5 will be equals to B to the power 32. As we are given with A to the power 5 equals to E by the rule proof, we know that A, if A5 equals to E, this implies that A to the power minus 5 will also equals to E. That's why we will have E is equals to B to the power 32. That means B equals to B to the power 32. If we multiply it by B inverse, we will have B to the power 31 equals to E. That simply means the order of B is 31. Next question is, let Z asterisk be an algebraic structure where Z is a set of integer and the operation asterisk is defined as N cross N asterisk M equals to maximum of N cross N comma M. Which one of the following statement is true for Z asterisk? The given algebraic structure does not have any identity element. Since it is defined on the set of integer and there is no minimum element in the set of integers, since it does not have any identity element, it is not a monoid, it is not a group, and consequently it is not an abelian group. So the correct answer will be option number 4. Next question is, if x plus 1 is a factor of x to the power 4 minus x cube plus kx plus 5, then k, the value of k will be, as we know that if x minus a is a factor of fx, then f of a will be equals to 0. Now, in this case, we have a is equals to minus 1. When we replace this x by minus 1, we will have minus 1 to the power 4 minus minus 1 to the cube plus k into minus 1 plus 5 is equals to 0. It will come out as 1 plus, it will be 1 minus k plus 5 equals to 0. That means k equals to 7. So the correct answer is option number 3, 7. Next question is, a group G is abelian if and only if for every AB belongs to G. Okay. In order to prove a group as an abelian group, we have to prove that AB is equals to BA. Okay, now when we take this AB square is equals to A square B square, then what we have to prove is that AB equals to BA. Now this can be written as AB equals to A B B. Simple. As this is a group, so these elements will be associative. So A, it can be written as A B A, B equals to A B B. Now multiply this left hand side by A inverse and this side by B inverse, and same with this term, means here we will have A inverse and this side will be B inverse. We will left with, as we know that A into A inverse will be E and B into B inverse will be E, we will have BA equals to AB. Means for this condition we have BA equals to AB, which is the condition for a group to be abelian group. So the correct answer is option number 3. Next question is, the relation of divisibility in the set of non-zero integer is, as we know that they will fulfill the property of transitive, because if A is divisible by B and B is divisible by C, then definitely A will be divisible by C. We can verify this property easily. So the relation is transitive, but it is not symmetric. But as we know that if 4 is divisible by 2 but 2 is not divisible by 4, the only possibility we have is if A is divisible by B and B is divisible by C. It only happens when we have A equals to B. So this is the condition of antisymmetry. That's why the relation is antisymmetric, and it is reflexive also, because we are having the set of non-zero integers. Hence the correct answer will be option number 2, reflexive, antisymmetric and transitive.